This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Friday the 25th of May. I'm Georgina White. Another Spanish fishing incursion fuels dispute. Macaque expert in Gibraltar to conduct study. ATCOM chairman re-elected at annual general meeting. UK media reports on Guardia Civil call for backup. Air crash disaster exercise. And finally, Orange Peel and Lost News to play at Rock on the Rock. A further incident occurred at around 11 p.m. last night between three RGP vessels, two GDP vessels and one Navy boat. The forces approached the five fishing vessels, three of which had cast their nets, and informed them that they were breaking the law and would be dealt with through the local judicial process. The fishermen were brought into Gibraltar's territorial waters by four Guardia Civil boats and a helicopter. The Guardia and fishermen eventually left at 12:45 a.m. Three local amateur photographers managed to catch the scene 200 metres from the detached mole. In Gibraltar to conduct a research project, Professor Agustin Fuentes has been working with GONS to develop a macaque management plan to improve the management of the rock's vast population. YGTV spoke to Professor Fuentes for more information.
Thank you very much for speaking to us today, Professor Fuentes. Tell us a bit about your research here in Gibraltar.
Well, in about 2006, I came out here to do some preliminary work with GONS and the excellent group of researchers that they have ongoing looking at the management behavior of the monkeys. And so what I'm really interested in, and I do this in other places in the world too, is how is it that certain types of other animals do well around humans? And if one thing, your Barbary apes here do extremely well around people. So I'm interested in what makes it such that a big mammal, like the monkeys you have here, can live around all of these people and do so successfully. So that's the bottom line. But the details are much more interesting. How do they do it? How do they relate to one another? Why do they fight with people? Why do they not fight with people? Why are they sometimes causing nuisances and other times not?
Okay, excellent. Sounds extremely interesting. And you are working closely with the Environmental Agency and GONS. What sort of things will you be putting into practice for your research?
Well, in the past, what we've looked at are human-monkey interactions, so the interaction between humans and the apes here, the patterns of those interactions. What is it that stimulates the apes to move from the rock into town, for example? What is it that keeps them from moving into town? Why sometimes would a small group break off and go to a hotel, and why might they not? So we're interested in the interactions between the monkeys and the humans, but also the monkeys' lives themselves. How do they interact with one another? How do the males and females interact? Why are they so interested in the young ones? This, if you've ever watched them, you know, it's both the males and females. They just want to hold those little ones. We're also have done recent work on their diet, what they're eating, and how that might impact their health. So going forward, what we really want to do are two things. One is get a better understanding of these incredibly rare and amazing creatures, the Barbary apes, and at the same time, really contribute as much as we can to effective management so that the coexistence between the apes and the humans here in Gibraltar lasts a long time.
Okay, and what are you expecting to find from your research?
Well, what we know is that food brings apes, and open rubbish bins, actual feeding, which in fact is illegal in Gibraltar, changes the behavior of the monkeys. And so impacting them, luring them down, they're very bright. If they know they can get food from you, they're going to seek you out and get it. And so what we'd like to do is figure out how to best change that practice here in Gibraltar, but at the same time, keep the interactions where people can see the apes and where there's still a big tourist revenue generated from that, so that the apes' lives are good and the humans' lives are good. That's the end goal of this.
Well, thank you very much for speaking to us.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
The Association of Trust and Company Managers, ATCOM, re-elected Barrister Makalul as chairman in the annual general meeting that was held earlier this week. Within his report, Chairman Makalul reported that ATCOM currently has its highest ever number of members, representing close to 90% of the industry, employing around 1,000 people. He outlined the work that had been done over the past year regarding reform proposals of the Companies Act, holding quarterly meetings with the FSC and various other matters. Gibraltar has caused a stir within UK and Spanish media this week. Following the various Spanish fishing incursions that have occurred in Gibraltar's territorial waters over the past few days, reports from Sky News have suggested that Spain's Guardia Civil Union have called on the government to deploy the Spanish Navy. Gibraltar and Spain's fishing spat has also made its way into the Daily Mail, Reuters and BBC News. an exercise to test the emergency response to a major incident at the Gibraltar airport, will take place on Tuesday, the 29th of May 2012. All emergency and essential services from both the Government of Gibraltar and the Ministry of Defence will take part. Also participating will be other departments and agencies that normally support the emergency and medical services. All levels of command will be activated. The scenario for the exercise involves a passenger aircraft, which has crashed on takeoff at the eastern side of the runway, breaking into on impact. And finally, local band Orange Peel will be playing alongside Los News from Seville tonight at Rock on the Rock. Seville band Los News will perform tracks from their debut album, Automedication. Entrance fee is £3 and the set starts at 10:30 p.m. That's all YGTV News, I'm back on Monday. Have a great weekend.